Welcome student, today I am going to discuss a new topic called exception handling. In the previous lecture, we had discussed deadlock in multithreading. What are the various techniques we can use so that deadlock cannot be arise in our program? We also discuss about difference between the deadlock and starvation. In this chapter, I am going to discuss those following topic. First, I will start the lecture with some brief introduction about the exception. What is exception? Why exception handling is required? Then I will discuss about the some runtime stack mechanism, which is very important to get the concept of exception hierarchy. Then I will discuss about the default exception handling in Java, exception hierarchy, customize exception handling by using try catch block, how do I handle our exception in our program. So how to use the try catch block to handle the such type of situation. Then I will discuss about control flow in try catch block, how the flow of execution happened if I use the try catch block, and what are the method are available to print the exception information. Then I will discuss about try with multiple catch blocks. So only try block, then followed by several catch block. Then there very, very important topic, finally block, and what are the difference between the final, finally and finalized. This question is very, very important for your exam. Most of the time we will get that kind of question, what is the difference between the finally and finalized. Then I will discuss about some try catch finally block and different type of try catch finally block where we can use, and how do I use the try catch finally block in different way. Then we will discuss between the throw keyword and throws keyword, and I will explain the difference between the throw and throws keyword. And the last topic of this chapter is customize or user defined exception. How do I use my own exception class so that we can handle any type such type of exception mechanism, handling mechanism. So how do I handle this such type of exception? I will use the customize or user defined exception. In this chapter, basically I am going to discuss in this lecture about exception handling, runtime stack mechanism, and how do I handle the default exception in Java. Okay, let's start with the first introduction. So what is exception handling? So the exception handling in Java is one of the most powerful mechanism to handle the runtime error so that normal flow of the application can be maintained. So before going into details of what does mean the exception handling, we have to know what is exception. So exception means an exception which is unexpected, unwanted event that disturbs the normal flow of program is called exception. So exception means an unexpected unwanted, because I don't want any event that will disturb my normal execution of a program. So unwanted, unexpected, that two term is very important. Unwanted event that disturb normal flow of the program is called exception. This is very, very important, unexpected, unwanted event. So let me take a small analogy so that you can understand those terms. What does mean the unexpected? What does mean unwanted event? So in respect to exception handling, assume that one of your friend live at Goria. Okay, and he wants to attend college on time, so GMIT. So he has started his journey at 9 o'clock in the morning, because normally class has started from 10:15. So around 1 hour. So you know that he will reach the destination on time. So he started his journey at 9 a.m. Okay, 9 o'clock in the morning on motorcycle. So he has to reach at 10 a.m. so that he can continue his class on time. So it will take 1 hour at least, and somewhere in between Goria and Baraipur GMIT. So somewhere, let's say at Kamalgachi Mor. Okay, so he start his journey in the 9 o'clock in the morning on motorcycle, and at Kamalgachi Mor, after crossing the signal, suddenly tire got puncture. Okay, suddenly here tire got puncture. So what will happen? So your friend should go back to the room by walk along with his bike, or it may be happen leave the bike over there only and then take a auto and come back to the class, or he will try to repair the bike then came back to the college, or it may be he will park his bike on some known place or any parking zone then came back to the college. So I am not going to details what will happen after that, but here I am only interested is tire puncture. Okay, I am just only interested in this event. So if there is no unexpected event, so I can think is a unexpected event. So unexpected, unwanted, I don't want the my his tire, he don't want his tire will get puncture. So this is unexpected and unwanted event that happened suddenly that disturb the normal journey or disturb his normal journey. So this unexpected unwanted event in our program, so that disturb the normal execution of the program is called exception. So let's conclude this definition. An exception is an unexpected, unwanted event that disturb normal flow of the execution. Let me take another example in respect of our programming language. In technical example, suppose I have a Java program and I want to read a file, that file, or I want to read a file or data, or read data from a file, that file locating at, I want to read a remote file locating at, for example, London. Okay. So my program execution start normally from here. So when the program wants to access this file, the file is not available. File not available. Right? So what will happen? If file is not available, what will happen? The program execution will stop immediately. So that means it's a abnormal termination, because the program wants to access a file, but file is not available. What will happen? Just stop the program execution abnormally, right? So this type of situation, because here the program wants to access a file, but the file is not available. So it is unexpected. It is unexpected event. So that kind of situation is called exception. Now we have clear about what does mean the exception. Now my question is, it is recommended to handle the exception? It is recommended. So, or we can say, what is the purpose of exception handling? Obviously, it is recommended, highly recommended to handle the exception. That is the purpose of exception handling, because you always try, or you can say the main objective of exception handling is to graceful termination of the program. So that means we do not want to lose any information. So I want to stop my execution of a program normally. I don't any unexpected event may arise in my program. So exception handling is very, very essential. So it is highly recommended to use exception handling. So in my example, in exception handling does not mean that we are going to repairing an exception. We may have to provide a alternative way to continue the rest of the program start normally. That is the concept of exception handling. So we are not going to repair any exception. We are just providing a normal or alternative way so that my program will execute normally. For example, in my program requirement, I want to read a file locating at London. But if the file is not present or not available at London, what will happen? So I don't want to terminate the program. I want to provide some local file so that my program execution continue. Right? So this way of defining the alternative is called exception handling. Right? Or you can say the exception handling in Java is one of the powerful mechanism to handle the runtime error so that normal flow of the application can be maintained. Right? So now you are clear what does mean the exception and what does mean exception handling. So there are several ways we can handle the exception. Before that, let me explain with this example in technically what does mean exception handling. So suppose, don't worry about that, I will discuss what does mean the try and what is catch. So right now I want to say that if any sensitive code or risky code that going to arise any exception, I will put those code in my try block, right? So read data from remote file. Remote file locating at London and use. So what kind of error may be arise in this example? So file not found exception. Say if any file is not available, if I want to access this file, if the file is not available, let's say it will give an exception. The name of the exception is file not found exception. File not found exception. Don't worry, we'll discuss what does mean the file not found exception, when it will be arise. I'll discuss in later. Right now, just considering the I just want to make a concept, what does mean the exception handling or how can I handle this type of exception. So use, instead of that I will use a local file and continue rest of the program normally. Rest of the program normally. So I want to say that if I want to, or if you face any risky code or in your program, if you have any risky code which may arise any exception, just like in this example, when the file is not available, so that type of code which are very risky has to kept in a try block, and after that I have to write a catch block. Within the catch block I will write the alternative way by which you can handle the exception. So here if this file is not available, remote file is not available, I'll use any local file so that my program will continue normally. So that type of situation, that type of programming we are expecting. That's why exception handling is one of the important tasks as a programmer. Because if I don't handle the exception, so what will happen? So my program will stop abnormally. Later we'll discuss what will happen if I don't use the exception handling, right? So let me move into the next topic, that is runtime mechanism. Runtime stack mechanism. Suppose I have a program, right? I am just discussing a simple program so that you can understand. So I have a class. Name of the class is, for example, test. Okay. So within this class, I have a public, static, void, main, string. Arcs. Within that I have a method that is called doStack. It's a name actually. So name of the method is doStack, and this doStack method I have just declared public static doStack void return type, then doStack. So within this method I have called another method that is called do more stuff. Okay. Then I have just declared public static void do more stuff. system.out.println hello. I going to paint on screen hello. So my class is ended with a second curly braces. Now what does mean the runtime stack actually? Whenever a thread, we know that in this program how many thread, we already know what is thread. So in this program how many thread? Only one thread, that is main thread. So who is calling the main method? JVM is calling the main method, right? So whenever for every thread, JVM will create a runtime stack for every thread. If I create another thread, in the last previous lecture we had seen that when we had discussed about the thread. So whenever we are creating a thread, a new runtime stack is created. So in this example, how many stack are there? Only one thread. So that means only one thread will be created. So first, when JVM call the main method, they are call the main method, a runtime stack will be created. Runtime stack will be created, and each method call performed by that will be stored in the corresponding stack. So in this, so which one is the first method? Main method. So first, main is a method which will be stored in runtime stack, and main internally called do stub method. So that record has to also put in our runtime stack. So do stub, and do stub also called do more stub. So do more stub. Okay, that function main called do stub, do stub called do more stub. So that is the flow of execution. So each entry in the corresponding stack is called stack frame or stack activation record. So here how many entry are there? 3 entry. One of the method is for main method, another is for do stub method, and another is for do more stub, this method. So each of the entry is called stack frame or activation record. So after completing each of the method, all the corresponding entry from the stack will be removed. So what does mean? So if I execute this program, what will be the output? So first main method will be executed, it will call do stub method, no problem. So do stub method will call do more stub method, okay, and that method will be executed and I will get the output as hello. Okay, so when do more stub is completed, the corresponding entry from this runtime stack will be deleted, right? So that will be deleted. Then when do more stub complete, then do stub also. So then after completing this one, so control back to the do more stub method, and do more stub also complete, it will remove from this one. When do stub complete, then main method will be also complete. So main entry for this track will be deleted. So after completing all the method call, the stack will become again, that is empty, and under that empty stack will be destroyed by the JVM just before the terminating the thread, right? When all the execution is over, then JVM automatically destroy this runtime stack, right? So that all about the runtime stack mechanism. So here I want to say that whenever a method is called, or we can say a thread is created, automatically a runtime stack is created by JVM, and whatever the method has been called by this thread, that has to put in our runtime stack. So in this example, main is the one of the method. So main method is enter into a runtime stack first, and main internally called destroy method. Destroy method internally called Dumo stub method. So when the Dumo stub method complete, it completely removed from this runtime stack, entry will be removed from the runtime stack. Then do stub method complete, then do stub method will be complete, entry will be removed from runtime stack. Then again main method is complete, then the entry from Dumo stub will be entry from runtime stack, the main entry will be removed. That how the stack will work, or you can say the mechanism of stack in Java, right? Now the next topic is how to handle the default exception, or you can say default exception. Let me take the same example so that you can understood. So the next topic is default exception handling in Java. I am just taking the same example. So we have already discussed this class belongs to how many method? 3 method. One of the method is called main method, main called do stub, and do stub called do more stub, then do more stub will be executed. So let me modify here. So instead of hello, I want to print system dot out dot print. I want to print 10 by 0. Suppose I want to print. So what will happen? Is it possible to define any number by 0? So it will not possible. So if it is not possible, what will be the output of this program? So it will give an exception, but I don't know what kind of exception is it. But right now you have to understand it will not possible. So what will happen? So it will arise some exception in Dumo stub. When this Dumo stub method exception arise at Dumo stub method, so we already discussed exception must be handled. So what will happen? JVM, so it will print, or it will give the output exception. I am just writing what will be the output if I compile this program. So it will give me exception in thread main, and I am just writing simple term writing. And it will give arithmetic exception followed by front slash and by 0, or we can write by 0, and at this is the position where the exception may arise. So at Dumo stub, so test is the class name, so it will give first test dot do more stuff, at Dumo stub internally called by which method? Do stuff. So at test dot do stuff, and it is also called by internally main method. So test dot main, so that information will give an exception. So that information will print our computer screen, right? So why it is happening? Because here an exception is arise. So that information will be printed in our computer screen. So what will happen? After that, where the method has been created, exception. So this method, this exception is within DOMO stub. So this method will create a exception, create an exception, and it will give this information with, it will give an exception object and it will give the information, name of the exception. What is the name of the exception? Arithmetic exception. Arithmetic exception. What is the description? Description of the this part will be created by this method, description by 0, okay, division by 0. And what is the location? That location, that location at test dot do dot do more stuff, test dot do stuff at test dot main. This part is called location. This is location, this is description, and this is the name of the exception. So three information: name, description, and location. That information will goes to the JVM, right? And after that, this information, when the information will take by the or will reach to the JVM immediately get back to the spot, and it will check, JVM will check, is there any exception handling code is there in this method. So they will ask to do more stack, is there any exception handling code have you done? So there is, it will found that there is no exception handling block or code within DOMO stuff. Later you will know that how to handle the exception. Right now, for sake of simplicity, please try to understand there is no exception handling code is here, because I will handle with the help of try-catch block. So here in this program, I have not written any try-catch block. So this method is not handled by exception. So it simply get the information, the who is called this method. From this stack, it will understand that it will called by destroy method. Okay. So he just immediately cross the entry from DOMO stuff and get back to the destroy method. Then again you will check. Is there any handling code is there? Exception handling code. Here also there is no handling exception code. So you will corresponding entry from the stack will be deleted and get back to the main method. Then again check in their main anywhere, is there any handling code, exception handling code? If it is not present, in this example it is not present. So simply it will remove the entry, corresponding entry from the runtime stack, and simply delete the runtime stack or destroy the runtime stack and stop the program abnormally. So what will happen? So if there is no thread is available, okay, so nobody in this do more stuff, do stuff and main, no, none of the method has been fine. None of the method has been written any exception code, right? So it's just delete the main entry from the runtime stack. Then who is calling the run method? JVM calling the run method. So now it's responsibility of JVM to handle this exception. Then it will call a default exception handler to handle this situation. So JVM is has an assistant that is called default exception handler, and it will just print this message to this computer screen by handling this situation. So that is called default exception exception handling in Java. So what has been the default exception handling in Java? If none of the method has been written any exception handling code, then JVM will take care by with the help of default handler, exception handler. It will just print the exception, whatever the exception, what is the name of the exception, what is the description of the exception, so that the people can understand, and where the exception has been taken place. So that all information will print to the computer screen and simply delete the runtime stack or stop the normal execution or of the program, or you can say abnormal execution of a program. So simply shut down the program, right? So in this lecture we are familiar with what is exception. So we know that exception is an exception, unwanted, unexpected event in the program which stop the normal execution of the program is called exception. What is exception handling? What is exception handling? So exception handling in Java is one of the most powerful mechanism to handle the runtime errors so that normal flow of the application to be or can be maintained. Why exception handling is required? How many way we can handle the situation? What is the function of, or we can say how the runtime stack works in Java? How can I handle any default exception, or we can say default exception in Java? If is that no method has been handled the exception code, then handle the exception, then how we can handle the exception, that is default exception handling code. So it is clear to you, and in the next lecture I am going to discuss the more important topic in exception, that is exception hierarchy. I will also discuss about what is check exception, what is uncheck exception, what is the fully check exception versus partially check exception. So I will discuss about the normal flow of try clutch block. Everything I will cover in the next lecture. Thank you.